Howdy, howdy, my beautiful Sagittarius. How are you doing today, darling? Let's get into your weekly tarot reading today, Sagittarius, for October. See what's going to be happening for you today, all right? Now, when it comes to receiving your tarot readings on YouTube or on any other platform, Sagittarius, be sure to check out more than just your one zodiac sign. Check out your sun, moon, and your rising sign to see what's going to be happening in your life, all right? Now, if you enjoy this tarot reading here today, Sagittarius, be sure to check out the top right-hand corner, all right? That'll take you to your monthly tarot reading, and let me know in the comments below how it resonates with you. All right, and so let me know as well if you enjoy this tarot reading, and let's begin. All right, Two of Wands coming in here, in the back of the deck energy for you, Sagittarius. What you don't see coming here is your future is looking really promising here. All right, Sagittarius, the Two of Wands is a card of contracts. It also represents pay attention far out into the future. What is Spirit trying to get your attention in, Sagittarius? All right, let's see what Spirit's trying to get your attention with. All right, that Two of Wands, Three of Cups. All right, right off the bat, you have in the coming days here with that Three of Cups, future connections coming forward to you, something that you manifested with that magician energy. Maybe you did like a love ritual or like a soulmate ritual coming forward to you. Doesn't have to be romantic. And then the Page of Wands. Okay, so pay attention to the coming future for you here, Sagittarius, because it seems to be like in a lot of fronts for you, a lot of exciting news. So let's start delving into this energy deeper. All right, so Page of Wands is the card that comes right before the Two of Wands, actually. All right, and so Page of Wands represents new opportunities coming in, like a path to, like a new passionate path that'll, like, you know, I always say it's like a new interest, something that captures your attention and takes up a lot of your time here. Magician energy coming in as well, so this is a sense of where it's like for you, Sagittarius, you could be having like a new job coming in here, a new opportunity. All right, and especially with that Three of Cups, this can represent a celebration. All right, victory over something here. And so I feel like for you, Sagittarius, is like you're manifesting some really solid opportunity here, maybe like a contract for a new workplace situation here. All right, but it's like in the future for you, it's looking really solid. All right, I wouldn't be surprised. Again, I want to say this one last time. This is not going to be for everybody. It's going to be obviously very specific to my Sagittarians who on some point in time in September, maybe you did like a soulmate ritual, something associated with some type of magic, or maybe you asked your spiritual team or something. Like, I feel like there's just some type of calling of like wanting to have a person come into your life. Maybe you've been craving like a new friendship or something like that. I feel like you're definitely manifesting that, is a message that I get, but that's only if you did that recently. All right, that's the side message that I get. Let's explore this more. Knight of Pentacles coming in here. All right, and then the Knight of Cups, hello, with this Hermit card energy. Wow. All right, so for one, two different court cards coming in while you're in that hermiting phase. So it seems to be naturally very complementary of this Three of Cups here. More than one type of connection coming forward to you, multiple. You might be joining like a new friend group coming in here as well. All right, that's one way. Now, clarifying this and more so just your own projects and your own objectives here, Sagittarius, this is like a sense of where you've been in this hermit mode for a long time now, and I feel like you've been calling in these knights, all right, calling in the pentacles, calling in the cups here. All right, this is definitely some type of manifestation of your own work here. Let's get a little bit more clarification on this, because it's like stuff is being brought forward to you, opportunities brought, being like something's being offered that you're calling in here. Queen of Wands with the Page of Swords, my god. Back of the deck energy even is the Star energy. This is some powerful stuff here, Sagittarius. All right, be sure to stick until later on when we do your oracle cards here, because I can't wait to see how the oracle cards play off of this, Sagittarius. All right, so that's later in the video, so be sure to watch for that. But it's like Queen of Wands, Page of Swords energy coming in here. Very, very, very strong message here, Sagittarius, where it's like, I'm being shown like, I don't, it's that old cartoon where it's like Pepe Le Pew and he was like obsessed with like a skunk or something, a female animal. There's some type of animal, I don't know. But that's like the message I get with this, where it's just like you're having like Pepe Le Pews being attracted to you. Genders obviously don't matter here. All right, I feel like you're attracting some very extroverted energy here. Regardless, now getting back into your own personal objectives here, Sagittarius, a message that I do get is the sense of how do we want to put this here, Sagittarius? There's a time and a place of when it's going to be important for you to leave your shell and be about action here. I see that you've been keeping your eye on something in particular, all right? And there's going to be a point in time where you're going to have to leave that hermiting phase and go out and grab it and get it to claim the energy, essentially, here, right? There's this message here, Sagittarius, where it's like you want to claim a specific type of energy and you have to wait until the right moment to just like go out there and claim it for yourself. It's not going to come knocking on your door. You're doing a lot of spiritual work or, you know, energetic work to bring forth these doors. It's like you're wanting doors to be open for you. But little do you know, Sagittarius, you're manifesting doors to be coming, like being presented for one and coming closer to you. But there is like this message here where it's like you have to take the final steps, Sagittarius, to fully claim the energy. I don't know why there's this obsession I'm getting right now, because I usually don't talk about claiming anything, but there is this message here where it's like I do feel like there's going to become a point where you're claiming what's rightfully yours, Sagittarius. Now let's go into this just a little bit deeper with these tarot cards here. What else is going to be happening for you? This card wanted to come out, the Emperor card. I really see you gaining a lot of attention here, Sagittarius. I don't know, it feels like October seems to be a month where everyone wants a piece of you, Sagittarius. Like I see for you, it's like people trying to chat you up, and this is like really stroking your ego. I feel like that's another message here as well, is like this sense of like you're being like, October is going to be a month of feeling really validated for who you are and like what you've accomplished. Like I really feel like you're developing like a swagger here, Sagittarius, in the coming days here. Temperance energy here with the Six of Pentacles. Yeah, Sagittarius, October for you is going to be a month of just progressively you having more and more to celebrate, to a point of where it's going to be struggle. It's going to be like a struggle for you to not come off as cocky, all right? And I feel like for you, Sagittarius, it's not that I'd see you as someone that's cocky, but it's like everything good that's about to happen to you, it's not the sense of entitlement or where you just feel like things just deserve to be given to you just because you exist. But there's this sense of entitlement. There's this sense of authority that I feel like you have, because it's like you're proud of what it is that you capture. You know, when like if you ever had cats, like sometimes a cat will just like capture like a bird or a lizard and they drop it in front of you so proudly, being like, look what I caught. That's how I see this energy as, is the sense of where, not that you're bringing it to somebody, but it's like you're able to boast about what happens, because it's just like this is through your own creation with that magician energy. Like there's a sense for you, I feel like, on some level, Sagittarius, where you're just like, holy crap, do I have like some type of superpower from what it is that you're able to create or manifest, especially in the social departments. Like I really feel like you're going to be blown away, Sagittarius. For example, if you've like wrote down attributes about a person, like about like your soulmate or twin flame or what have you, I feel like you're about to be really blown away by your potential of like what you magically can do. I don't know, I think you understand what I'm trying to express, Sagittarius. All right, again, I can't wait until we get to the oracle cards for that, but let's firstly talk about your social life, Sagittarius, right? Because it seems to be pretty strong in y'all's reading in general. But let's see, for you, we could be tapping into a past, current, or future relationship in your life, platonic, romantic, or family related. All right, I don't put labels on it. Let's take a look here, Saggy. Devil card coming in, Five of Wands. This card kept on trying to come out during this entire time when I've been shuffling, by the way. All right, so Judgment card, Five of Wands, and the Devil energy here. First and foremost, Sagittarius, I feel as if Spirit's going to be exposing some type of devil in your life here. I feel like, I don't know, you know, a specific message I get, Sagittarius, it's like someone in your family, either someone in your, I want to say more so family than like friend circle, friend group, but it's like someone in your family is going to be really revealing themselves to you about like their true feelings, their true intentions towards you. It's the sense of where Spirit's going to be exposing somebody and be like exposing them to showcase like the type of devil that they are. So, you know, being like, oh, I need to avoid this person here. And you might initially just get that through intuition, Sagittarius, all right? You might have ran into a person recently as well where you're just like, you know what? I can't put my finger on it, but I just don't vibe with this person. I don't have a good idea about this person, good feeling about this person, especially if it's like a friend, because I get this sense of like your friend or like a family member bringing someone into your space and you're just like, I don't like this person at all. You can't justify it with anything. It's just like a gut feeling. Three of Cups in the reverse comes out. So definitely in that exact scenario that I said, Sagittarius, or this is a situation of where you're going to realize like a friend that like Loki doesn't even like you. All right. Is going to be being revealed to you here. Temperance energy coming in here. And then we have the Death card coming in, Ace of Cups afterwards. So it's really interesting. It's like spirit showcasing to you like a really crappy person in your life. And they're just like, hey, like, there's this devil over here. You should be aware about it, you know, end that situation because we have someone better coming in for you. It's like they replace that crappy energy with something so much better for you. So it's kind of interesting. It's like spirit has wanted to for a while to get rid of someone in your life. But for whatever the reason is, it's been hard for them to be able to get you to separate your energy from them. So it's like by the time when you finally do like separate your energy from them, your spiritual team is like, oh, thank God Sagittarius did that. Finally, let's bring in some new energy for them to connect to distract them away from that crappy devil energy. That's how I see this as. So let's get into your oracle cards today, Sagittarius. See what kind of oracle reading you're going to be getting today, darling. All right. Balancing spirituality and practicality, full moon in Pisces coming in here. One more. Girl, can I grab it? And then we have releasing negativity, full moon in Scorpio. All right, taking these both in, balance spirituality and practicality, girl. And it's time to release negativity. Let's get some clarity cards on this here. Firstly, what I see with this here, Sagittarius, you can't fix them. That's the first message I get here. It's just like, accept that you can't fix a situation. You can't fix a person. Even if you see their potential, you kind of have to just be, yeah. That's what this is here, Sagittarius, is like, I see you really wanting to make it work with like a certain relationship in your life. Could be like a family member, because you're just like, you know what? I only have one mother. I only have one uncle, whatever it is, right? I really want to make it work. All right. It's like, I only have one last childhood friend or something. I really want to make it work. But I feel like you kind of have to accept a situation for what it is and be like, you know what? Love you, but I have to watch you from afar. Because for whatever the reason is here, Sagittarius, there's this sense of where you can't save them. You can't do anything to change their trajectory. You kind of just have to let them let go and let God and get back into your own life. Because I feel like if you care too much about the situation, it's going to consume you, consume your thoughts. And it's just like you'll obsess over it, because it's like when you care about people, it's like impossible for you to just like give up on them. Right. Let's see what else we got coming in for you here, Sagittarius. Let's see here. We have here the wall, obstacles, number 11, all right, in numerology. That's your number for this week, Sagittarius, so be sure to look that up. Obstacles coming in here. What are the obstacles that we're talking about? All right, we already acknowledged this, the obstacles in terms of your social life. I feel like spirit's going to be revealing to you whose energy that you've been around that has been holding you back, keeping your own energy down. See if this is the same thing or something else. Let's take a look here. Eight of Swords, Page of Pentacles, and then the Eight of Cups. I feel as if there's like some type of distaste when it comes to your work life, Sagittarius, or like when it comes to your money. Maybe you're not happy with how much you're making at your current job or whatever the case is. There is like this message here where it's like you're being too short-sighted. It's like you're unhappy with like a situation in your life, but you're also telling yourself that you can't leave it. You can't move on from it. So it's like you're telling yourself that you're stuck there, when in reality it's not that you're stuck there. It's you don't really want to go through the Eight of Cups experience with a situation and go into uncharted territory, right? Where it's just like so I feel like for you, Sagittarius, for example, if you have such a limited mindset on your potential of like running your own business, for example, or what have you, that's really where the message is coming in. So like your spirit saying, so you're being way too small-minded with like what it is that you think you can accomplish. Does that make sense, Sagittarius? That's how I see that oracle card playing off with that. Let's see what your animal, spirit animal is this week. Let's see here. Condor. Oh, Sagittarius, y'all be really being called out this week. Oh, girl. Saggy. So this card says, you're too enmeshed in the situation, Sagittarius, to step back and see the bigger picture before making any decisions or taking any actions. Bringing you right back to the beginning of your tarot reading here, Sagittarius, talking about the Two of Wands, looking far out into the future. So once again, Spirits is talking to you, Sagittarius, where it's just like, hey, right now your current environment is like whatever it is, right? Stop basing your current environment and thinking because of how your current environment is looking like right now, that's you have a general reference to what your future is going to be like. That's not the case whatsoever here. All right. Spirit's really trying to grab your attention from being so short-sighted into looking at the bigger picture. It's like Spirit's really trying to get you to understand where it is they're trying to guide you to, where is your path is taking you to, because it's like this sense of where I do feel like you get too focused on the details or too lost on the details. All right. So that's what I see on that, Sagittarius. All right, let's leave you with your mantra card for this week, Sagittarius. See what mantra card you're going to be taking with you. Ooh, I haven't seen this one. What does this say? My faith has power to turn trauma into healing, conflict into growth, and fear into love. That's powerful, Sagittarius. Let's say this again. My faith has the power to turn trauma into healing, conflict into growth, and fear into love. So this is really a message of just transmuting energies here. Your faith having the power to turn trauma into healing. All right. This is a situation where it's like whatever traumatic situations you're dealing with currently, see how that your current traumas is really adding fuel to your future in whatever way. All right. So even if it's in such a way where it's like you're realizing certain people are just not meant to be part of your life, just be thankful that it's healing for your future, so you know you don't have to take care of those snakes in the future, right? Conflict into growth, not allowing obstacles in your life to be a sign for you to give up, but instead to add more depth to you, to educate you further so you can again build a greater future. And fear into love, I feel like the fear is your fear for you to go out into the unknown, leaving your current situation that you're unhappy with into creating something that you love, creating the life that you love. All right. So it's all about that transmutation energy. So Sagittarius, this is the tarot reading that I have for you today, darling. Thank you so much for allowing me to do this today. Don't forget your monthly tarot reading, and I'll connect to you sometime in the near future. Bye, darling.